Okay, so now we'll go for the next chapter, that is chemical bonding. So if you go for chemical bonding, what is the exact meaning of chemical bonding? The electrostatic force of attraction or simply electrostatic force which binds two atoms in order to acquire stability. It's simply called as chemical bond. The electrostatic force of attraction or simply electrostatic force which binds the two atoms may be same or different. Here the two atoms may be same or they may be different in order to acquire stability is simply called as chemical bond. So when you go for chemical bond, a chemical bond takes place always between two atoms. Because we are saying that the chemical bond is taking place between two atoms, here suppose I am taking the first atom with a positively charged nucleus and one circular path, that is orbit, which is housed with the electron, and you take another atom, positively charged nucleus, and again the circular path, that is orbit, placed with an electron. So what is happening here is, if these are the two atoms, this is atom 1, this is atom A and this is atom B. So here you can see that the electron of the second atom, will try to attract the electrostatic force of attraction operates between the electron of the second atom and the nucleus of the first atom. Again, the electron of the first atom and the nucleus of the second atom, also you find that there is an electrostatic force of attraction operating between the nucleus of the second atom and the electron of the first atom. Again, the electrostatic force of attraction is operating between the nucleus of the first atom and the electron of the second atom. Also, you know very well that when these two atoms, this atom A and atom B, when they come closer to each other, you find that you are finding that both the atoms are made up of the nuclei, both the nuclei are positively charged, and if you take electrons, both the electrons are negatively charged. So there is a kind of electrostatic force of repulsion. So I can use two words here, that is when you go for nucleus to nucleus, this is electrostatic force of repulsion, and when you are going for electron to electron, again electrostatic force of repulsion. Electron of atom A and electron of atom B, the kind of forces operating are electrostatic force of repulsion, ESFR, electrostatic force of repulsion between electron to electron of both the atoms. Similarly, electron of first atom and nucleus of second atom, you find that electrostatic force of attraction occurs. Again, electron of atom B and nucleus of atom A. This is nucleus of atom A, electron of atom B. Again, you find that there is electrostatic force of attraction. If you take nucleus of atom A and nucleus of atom B, you find that electrostatic force of repulsion occurs. Electrostatic force of repulsion occurs. So that means we can draw one conclusion. The conclusion what we can draw is, between two atoms, we can put it in this way, between two atoms, electrostatic force of attractions are greater than electrostatic force of repulsions, ESFA, electrostatic force of repulsions, okay, if they are greater, then atoms combine, chemical bond is formed, a chemical bond is formed because both the atoms, they approach closer and a chemical bond is formed. On the other hand, if you take between two atoms, if you find that electrostatic force of attractions is less than electrostatic force of repulsions, then atoms do not combine and no chemical bond is formed. No chemical bond formation takes place. So from this illustration, it is very clear that between two atoms, always there are two types of forces. When the two atoms comes close to each other, between two atoms, electrostatic force of attractions operate between the electrons and the nucleus. So here, what we have to understand here is, between two atoms, always two types of forces are operating. One is electrostatic force of attraction and electrostatic force of repulsions. When electrostatic force of attractions between the two atoms dominate over the electrostatic force of repulsion, then the two atoms combine with each other. That means they approach closer to each other. Then the electrons, that is the valence electrons present in both the atoms, they involve in the bond formation. They try to share, and once the sharing takes place, the valence electrons involve in the bond formation. Once the bond formation is going to take place, then finally the bond formed is chemical bond. On the other hand, between the two atoms, if the electrostatic force of repulsions are dominating between the two atoms, then the electrostatic force of attraction, then it is difficult for both the atoms to come closer to each other. When they are unable to come closer to each other,